found a McDonald's bag in a bin, emptied it out, put it over my hand, walked in, growled at them and said, give me all the money or I'll blow your heads off. And they put all the money up on the counter. I walked out with $7,000. My name is Noel Smith. I used to be known as Razor Smith back in my criminal days. I spent 32 years in British prisons. I'm now a writer and a journalist. I appeared on a Lad Bible video called The Gap, where I met a younger criminal called Kulnai. Every time I went out of my house, I had to check that I had at least one weapon with me. One was normally a gun. I used to carry a knife as well as a gun. Sometimes I would carry two guns, a knife and a stun gun.
Jeez.
I've never looked at any of the comments that appear underneath these videos. So I'm here to pick up on what people have been saying about it. This one says, the old guy's name is Noel Razor Smith. I don't want to know where Razor came from. After I became a criminal, I started to carry a cutthroat razor, and one day I was in a club down in Brixton when we were attacked and I ended up using the razor. I slashed somebody across the face and realised the power of that. He stopped immediately hitting me and legged it away with his face pouring with blood. And then all the old teddy boys afterwards were all proud of me. They put their arms around my shoulder, bought me a drink even though I was 15. And started calling me Razor, and that kind of nickname just stuck. I have to be honest, it was quite a psychological weapon to have a nickname like that. Right, yeah, violence can be an addiction. Most gangster shit I ever heard, this old dude is a real G. Thanks for that, I think. Nice to know I'm a real G. And violence, yes, violence can be an addiction. I've been a violent offender all my life. When you go out to commit serious crime, you're putting your life on the line. It's a life and death gamble every time, especially if you're an armed robber, because the only people who are going to be coming after you is not going to be your local Bobby on his push bike with his truncheon. It is armed police who have got previous for shooting very many armed robbers in this country. Seriously, look it up. They shoot to kill. I got shot at by the police in 1992 when I was on the run from prison. I was committing armed robberies. I'd escaped. I was out for 79 days. I escaped from the Verne prison. Being on the run is a very expensive business. So in my first 3 weeks, I think I robbed 13 banks. And I'd been involved in a shooting incident. And all of a sudden, police cars flopped on me from everywhere, come skidding up. They all jumped out. And shouting armed police, stick your hands up, with Heckler and Koch submachine pistols. And being the criminal I am, I put my foot down on the car, went up on the pavement, and they chased me. As I'm speeding across the common, a flying squad car came up beside me with a cop leaning out, pointing the gun at my head, and said, if you don't stop the car, I'm gonna shoot you in the head, shouting it across to my car, and I wound the window up. As if that was going to stop a 9mm bullet coming through. But anyway, I have to say that, you know, to be honest, I do miss the adrenaline rush of committing crime a little bit. You know, I don't want to do any criminal things, but I have criminal habits. So for example, I can be walking down the high street and I see a security van delivering to a bank or a post office. And immediately, as an automatic response, I look at my wristwatch to check what time it is, because when you're a criminal, when you're a robber, that's what you're doing. You're watching vans all the time. You're marking the time they're there, so they might be there next week at the same time and you can set up a robbery on them. Did he ever meet the Crays? I did come across Reggie Cray when I was in Maidstone prison. I was in Highdown prison with Lenny McLean when he got done for the murder outside the nightclub up in London. He was quite funny. I see him knock a geezer out through the window. That was quite impressive. The sort of high profile names that I came across in prison were, I was good friends with Charlie Bronson, still am, you know. Charlie's all right, he's still stuck in prison. Personally, I don't think they're gonna let him out, even though he hasn't killed anybody. And some of the things that happen in prison are really, truly horrific. I mean, they got a thing called teabagging. Now, I know teabagging out here is a completely different thing. Apparently, it's got sexual connotations. But in prison, to be teabagged means to be stabbed many times with sharp instruments. Normally, three or four people will pounce on you in the shower and stab you as many times as they can. And it's called teabagging because the old Tetley tea advert teabag advert used to talk about 1,000 perforations. And that's what they hoped to leave you with, would be 1,000 perforations. I was in the dinner queue one day, one Sunday, and there's about, I don't know, 50, 60 guys queuing up. And all of a sudden, three fellas with masks, homemade masks, come down to get someone in the queue, jumped him, stabbed him in front of all of us. They're all masked up. Started stabbing him, left him with about 40 stab wounds. He's fell to the floor. It's very quick. It happens very quick. They went off to throw away their masks and get rid of the weapons and clean up. And the guy in front of me stepped over the stabbed body and said to the hot plate geezer, "I'll have his slice of roast beef. He don't want it." And I thought to myself, this, I just looked around and I thought, this is the world I'm living in now. This is it. The next one, Bruce Willis would play him in the movie, lol. I do believe that a lot of armed robbers are sort of frustrated actors. You have to gear yourself up. You have to prepare for your role. When I'm on a robbery, I'm known as the frightener, someone who carries the gun and does the growling. So I know I'm capable of actually controlling people and controlling crowds just with a wave of a gun and shouting. For those few moments, you have to make people actually believe that you would rather leave them with bullet holes in them than not get the money. In reality, that's not the truth. I often done robberies with real and loaded firearms. There were several occasions when, you know, you just can't get hold of anything. One occasion, found a McDonald's bag in a bin, emptied it out, put it over my hand, walked in, growled at them, said, "Give me all the money or I'll blow your heads off," and they put all the money up on the counter, and I walked out with $7,000. I know a guy had done banana, man. He used to do robberies with banana in a bag and then eat the evidence. And then there was the cucumber kid who used to do robberies with a cucumber. And I know someone who sawed off an iron in bald legs and pretended it was a shotgun. Did my G say 2.7 million in 35 years? Could have made that in a day job, fam. Really? You can make 2.7 million in 35 years in a day job. The actual money I stole was enough to keep me sort of living in the life of luxury when I was out. But bear in mind, I wasn't out for that long. You know, I would have, the longest I would have out would be a year, and then I'd be back in for 6 or 7 years or 10 years or 12 years. So what we used to do was we'd get the money and we'd spend the money. Money was there for having a good time, and we always had it in the back of our mind. It was always a thought that if we run out of money, we'd just go and rob another bank tomorrow. Anyone who lived through the 1980s when Thatcher was in power will know that the mantra and the creed of this country was greed is good. You know, we took that on board as well, everyone did. Greed is good, so let's get out there and get what we want, take it and don't think a second about it, you know what I mean? And that was the kind of the mantra of this country. It hasn't really changed a lot, to be honest with you. It's just that I've got older. Right, this one says, the sad part is that the police created him. And you know what, I have to agree with that to a certain extent. I was bunking school with a friend of mine back in the 1970s. I was 14 years old, so was he. And we were walking down a street in Gypsy Hill in South London when an old Comer van pulled up and several plainclothes men jumped out, smelling heavily of drink, and grabbed hold of us and dragged us into the van. And they beat us so badly and tortured us so badly that we admitted to 60-odd burglaries that we had never committed. We found out afterwards they were an undercover police squad, a burglary squad from Gypsy Hill Station, who had a terrible reputation already. I thought, well, you know, if a criminal is what you want, that's what I'm going to give you. I know it's spiteful and petty, but I was a child. I was 14. The police put the seed in, but I grew the tree. 3 decades of your life in jail, what a waste of talent. I'd say thank you for that, saying I'm talented, that's quite good. And you're right, 3 decades of life in jail is an absolute waste. And it doesn't matter if you have no talent, spending 3 decades in prison is not a good idea. And I really seriously regret it. All criminals can change. I honestly believe that, you know, without redemption, what is the point of rehabilitation? If we don't think that people who commit horrible crimes can actually be changed, then we might as well just execute them when they commit their first crime, because, you know, they're just going to be a drain on society. There's nothing worse than people who are big bad criminals on the outside crying their eyes out when they get into prison because they got a bit of bird for what they're doing. Accept responsibility for your own actions. Accept responsibility for what you choose to do. I don't blame my life on anybody else. I actually chose to be a criminal. And that is a stupid thing to do. So yes, you're right. If you can't do the time, don't do the crime. What did you get sentenced for?
I had the cutting agent for cocaine. It's a legit thing, you know what I mean? It's legit, but it's just how you use it. So they said, oh, this guy, he's got 50 kilos of this shit, and he's obviously doing it with cocaine. What else is he gonna do it with? Yeah. I think in total, I got about 5 years, 8 months. What about you? You got a life sentence, right?
Yeah, I got life for armed robbery, possession of firearms and ammunition, conspiracy to rob, and possession of explosives.
Not a lot then.